Imagine you could go back and witness the birth of stars like our own, the cradle of countless worlds. Things were much simpler then. Look around you and you'll see mostly hydrogen gas and empty space. The initial cloud from which stars form is rarely spherical like this, but regardless, it doesn't take long for filamentary structure to emerge from the homogeneity. It's startling that the simple physics of turbulence and self-gravity can amplify even minute differences into such vast complexity. After about a million years, the first stars are born. In the core of some filaments, the pressure and temperature exceeds that needed to fuse hydrogen into helium. These pearls of light, strung like beads along their filament, may one day host planets, moons, and perhaps even life. These young stars are not quiescent like our own middle-aged sun, but instead are rambunctious, capricious even, as they suffer through the birth pangs of creation. Their rapid spins and nascent magnetic fields lead to the ejection of some of the infalling gas back into space, like a toddler tossing his food across the room in disdain. But looking from afar, one would be forgiven for thinking that the stars were celebrating their birth with fireworks stretching light years across. Amongst the cosmic choreography of these protostellar jets, none can compare to those of the most massive stars. These monsters let their presence be felt with gigantic jets, so powerful they greatly disrupt the flow of surrounding gas. It's an incredible sight, and also a fortunate act for stars like us. Without these outbursts, the greed of the massive stars would be unimpeded, and fewer stars would eventually result. Perhaps even we would not be here. From this vantage point, our everyday problems melt away. There is a sense of indescribable awe, unknowable majesty, and yet a sense of oneness, of connection. This is us, all of us. The constituents of our very flesh are somewhere buried within this maelstrom. Look closely, and in some cases, one can see some objects blowing bubbles, compression waves belched by the massive stars from their intense stellar winds. With so many massive stars now, their combined effect inhibits new star formation, expelling gas from the cloud altogether. There's so much happening now that perhaps, like our lives, we might wish just to freeze time just for a moment, to take a breath and just look at it. Just soak up the cacophony that gives birth to stars, the symphony of motion from which we all beget. From an initial blank slate, nature has crafted a scene of immense complexity and beauty, the wondrous hot mess of birth itself. As time resumes, voids begin to emerge from the forceful jets and bubbles that have plowed through the region. Around 6 million years have now transpired, and around some of the stars, planet formation will be well underway, forging the first gas giants from the crumbs left over. There's one last step we've yet to witness. Amidst this volume of gas, the most massive star that formed is around 30 times heavier than our sun. These are the James Deans of the universe, living a brilliant but brief existence. In less than 8 million years, it's already become unstable and is about to collapse inwards under gravity and then bounce back off its core in a staggering supernova event. To help us to visualize what will come, the colors we are seeing represent the speed of the gas particles, red being slow, yellow being fast, so the jets we are seeing are fast-moving gas. We pan back out for a better vantage point, for supernovae will affect the entire region. Indeed, when they trigger, they can briefly outshine the entire galaxy, such is their power. There. In that instant, it exploded, sending shockwaves across the region and enriching it with fused atomic elements. This chapter is now complete, but for many of these stars, the story is just beginning. And you, right now, are a part of that story, made from star stuff. a way for the cosmos to know itself.